Hi, this is Jen Lasser with Adobe Analytics Product Management. In this video, I'm going to give you an overview of the exciting new features we are releasing or already have released as part of the Spring 2018 Adobe Analytics release. The features are available to all analytics solution owners with the exception of Ad Analytics, and I'll mention the SKU requirements for that in just a few minutes. The Spring release includes tools for servicing GDPR requests for your users, search engine integration with advertising analytics, an ad hoc analysis to Analysis Workspace Project Converter, a new media collection API, a new integration with Power BI, and additional improvements to various features in the analytics UI. GDPR goes into effect on May 25th, 2018. As a data processor, Adobe is providing tools for data controllers, you, our customers, to be able to service access and delete requests from data subjects, your end users. We are releasing an Experience Cloud UI and API to orchestrate requests across all Adobe solutions. We have also released an analytics UI to manage data labeling so that when requests are made, we can return the necessary data based on the access or delete request. Before we can service any GDPR request, you must have your data retention period set and enforced to 25 months. Please work with your customer success manager to ensure this requirement is met. For more information on what Adobe is doing for GDPR, visit adobe.ly/GDPR. With advertising analytics, you can now surface your search data side by side with traditional analytics data. This integration is available to Adobe Analytics Select, Prime, and Ultimate customers that do not own AMO. I say do not own AMO because there is an existing integration that AMO customers already have today. The integration requires no additional implementation and can be easily turned on through the Analytics Admin Console. Ad Analytics extends to Google, Yahoo, and Bing search engines and integrates five metrics: cost, impressions, clicks, average position, and average quality score. The data is integrated at a summary level into the analytics dataset. In addition to these five metrics, several metadata classifications will be integrated as well, including ad platform, campaign, match type, and keyword. The new dimensions and metrics will be available in any Workspace project, in addition to a new pre-built search engine standard template. With the new Ad Hoc Analysis Project Converter, you can convert one or many projects at a time from Ad Hoc Analysis to Analysis Workspace with the click of a button. All the heavy lifting is handled by Adobe. We are releasing this to help you make a more seamless transition over to Analysis Workspace without losing all of the great project work you've built in the past. The new Media Collection API is another method for media data collection and is a complement to the existing Media SDK. The API extends video measurement to all current and future devices, including gaming consoles and VR devices. It will allow you to measure your streaming audiences more holistically to get a more accurate perspective on your customer reach. The Power BI Desktop Connector is the third integration we have with Power BI, the first two being content packs in Power BI and the ability to publish Report Builder dashboards to Power BI. This desktop connector will allow you to query Adobe data directly in Power BI. It introduces an opportunity because Power BI Desktop can also load any other data sources available in your organization and merge it with the Adobe data, allowing you to create concise, highly relevant business reporting for key stakeholders in one easy-to-access format. All three integrations are meant to give you more ways to democratize data and merge Adobe data with other non-Adobe data sources in Power BI. Within Analysis Workspace, we will be introducing tips to help you get the most out of Workspace. Each tip will provide a quick learning and a link to a video where you can see the tip in action. Tips can quickly be dismissed or disabled altogether if needed, with the option to retrieve them later on through help. Under the Help menu, you can now submit a customer care support ticket directly in the UI, rather than emailing customer care or your Adobe team directly. This option will be available for supported users and provides a way to submit more direct contextual feedback to us. This wraps up the overview of our 2018 Analytics Spring release. There will be individual deep dive videos on each of these features on our Adobe Analytics YouTube channel as well. We hope you guys enjoy all of these great new features.